Okay, good morning. Okay, objectives of this video lesson. After completion of this video lesson, you will be able to know condensation polymerization, examples for condensation polymerization, characteristics of reaction, addition and condensation polymerization, define a plastic, classify plastics, differentiate thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. These are the objectives of this video lesson. We discussed in this video lesson condensation polymerization, examples for condensation polymerization, characteristics of reaction, addition and condensation polymerization, define a plastic, classify plastics, differentiate thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. First we discuss about condensation polymerization. This condensation polymerization. Okay, listen. Groups such as OH, COOH, NH2 means hydroxyl group, carboxylic acid group, amine group have capacity to react with others. Which compounds have these groups? Those compounds react with others. Molecules carrying these groups means OH or COOH, NH2 are called functional monomers. These are functional groups. So, which molecules have these groups, those are called functional monomers. Example, adipic acid. Adipic acid contains two carboxylic acid groups, COOH, CH2O4, COOH. So, this is one of the functional monomer. Next, hexamethylene diamine. It contains two amine groups, NH2, CH2O6, NH2. This is hexamethylene diamine. Next, urea. Urea also contains two amine groups, NH2, CO, NH2. All these molecules or compounds contain above groups like OH, COOH, NH2. So these are called functional isomers, functional monomers. These react with other molecules. But listen, condensation is a process of removing molecules like water by reaction between two reactive monomers. Okay, suppose this is one functional monomer. This is another functional monomer. This functional monomer react with this functional monomer, then form polymer and also H2O molecule is removed. Okay, condensation is a process of removing of molecules like water by reaction between two reactive monomers. Suppose if you take any two reactive monomers, those two react, then water molecule is removed. So the process is called condensation. Okay, listen about the condensation polymerization. Condensation polymerization, also known as step growth polymerization. This polymerization is step growth polymerization. Functional monomers with reactive groups participate. That means which molecules have functional groups like OH, COOH, NH2. Those molecules are functional monomers. These functional monomers with reactive groups participate. So, these functional monomers participate in the condensation polymerization. In this polymerization, small molecules like H2O, CH3OH are removed in each step. In this polymerization, small molecules like H2O, NH3, CH3OH are removed in each step. Okay, this is the step growth polymerization. In this polymerization, functional monomers are participated. In this polymerization, H2O, NH3, CH3OH are like small molecules are removed in each step. Okay, this condensation polymerization is triggered by heating or mixing the monomers. This polymerization is triggered by heating or mixing the monomers. This polymerization reaction is slow. Addition polymerization reaction is fast. Condensation polymerization reaction is slow. Okay, reaction is slow. Next, low molecular weight polymers are formed. In the condensation polymerization, low molecular weight polymers are formed. So, less number of monomers present in this polymer. So, degree of polymerization is also low. Okay, in the addition polymerization, high molecular weight polymers are formed. So, more number of monomers present in the addition polymer. So, addition polymer degree of polymerization is high. But in the condensation polymerization, low molecular weight polymers are formed. So, less number of monomers present in the condensation polymer compared to the addition polymer. So, degree of polymerization is also low compared to the addition polymer. Okay, this is about the condensation polymerization. Listen, condensation polymerization. So, what is the definition of condensation polymerization? The polymerization in which many small or different functional monomers react to form a polymer with elimination of simple molecules like H2O, NH3, CH3OH, etc. is called condensation polymerization. Okay, listen, what is the definition of condensation polymerization? The polymerization in which many small different functional monomers are react to form polymer with elimination of simple molecules like H2O, NH3, CH3OH, etc. is called condensation polymerization. Okay, this type of polymerization generally occurs between different types of monomers. These are different types of monomers. In this process, simple molecules are formed as byproduct. Simple molecules like H2O, NH3, CH3OH are formed as byproduct, which are eliminated by condensation process. So, this type of polymerization is called cross-linked polymerization. Cross-linked polymerization. Addition polymerization is chain polymerization. Condensation polymerization is cross-linked polymerization. So, next we discuss example. Okay. Formation of nylon. Nylon is a condensation polymer. So, in this formation, adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine are participated. Okay. In the formation of nylon, adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine are participated. Adipic acid formula is this: COOH, CH2O4, COOH. Hexamethylene diamine formula is NH2, CH2O6, NH2. Okay, these two are participated in condensation polymerization. So, listen, like this. This COOH write like this OH. OH. This NH2 write like this H. Right, NH. Okay. When it is a minus H2O. Listen. Okay, in the condensation polymerization, We take example, formation of nylon. In the formation of nylon, adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine are participated. These two are different functional monomers. Okay, when these two are participated in condensation polymerization, in the OH, in the H of hexamethylene diamine react, and these two are eliminated as minus H2O, then bond is formed between CO and NH, CO and NH. Okay, when adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine are participating in a condensation polymerization, in the adipic acid OH group, in the hexamethylene diamine H, these two react and form H2O. This H2O is eliminated, and then bond is formed between CO and NH, then nylon is formed. Okay, in this condensation polymerization, adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine are participated. Simple molecules like H2O is eliminated, then nylon is formed. This is the example of condensation polymerization. Okay, next we take another example. That is formation of polyester or terlin. In the formation of polyester or terlin, terephthalic acid and ethylene glycol are participated. These two are different functional monomers. When these two are participated in condensation polymerization, in the terephthalic acid OH group, in the ethylene glycol H group, react and form H2O, and this H2O is eliminated. Then bond is formed between CO and O, then polyester is formed. Collision. In this terephthalic acid, it takes OH group. In the ethylene glycol, you take H. Okay. When terephthalic acid and ethylene glycol are participated in a condensation polymerization, OH group of terephthalic acid, H of ethylene glycol react and form H2O. This H2O is eliminated, minus H2O. When these two are participated in the condensation polymerization, collision. When these two, terephthalic acid, ethylene glycol, are participated in condensation polymerization, H2O is eliminated, then polyester or terlin is formed. This is the another example of condensation polymerization. Okay, we discuss another example of condensation polymerization. Okay, first we take two different functional monomers. Those are, one is phenol, another one is formaldehyde. This is phenol and formaldehyde. In presence of acid or alkali, these two are participated in condensation polymerization. First, methylol phenols are formed, orthomethylol phenol, this paramethylol phenol. This is orthomethylol phenol, this is paramethylol phenol. Okay, first phenol and formaldehyde are different functional monomers. These two are participated in condensation polymerization in presence of acid or alkali. First, ortho and para methylol phenols are formed. These two condensed. That means this OH This H collision. Take here H in the Lebesgue name, contains also one H. Here H2O molecule is eliminated like this. So this H2O molecule is eliminated. Condensation polymerization means H2O molecule is eliminated. So when H2O molecule is eliminated, this CH2 forms bond with this carbon. So CH2 form this carbon. Chelation. Okay. This is the formation of bakelite. In the formation of bakelite, first phenol and formaldehyde, these two are different functional monomers. These are participated in presence of acid and alkali. First form orthopara methyl alphenol. These two are participated in condensation. When then H2O is eliminated and form novaloc. This novaloc again condensed. And also, okay, this methyl alphenols react to form linear polymer called novaloc. This novaloc on heating forms three-dimensional cross-linked polymer. Three-dimensional cross-linked polymer. This is the bakelite. This is the another example of condensation polymerization. Okay, listen. In the formation of bakelite, first two different functional monomers, phenol and formaldehyde are participated in presence of acid and alkali. Then orthopara methylol phenols are formed. After formation, these two are participated in condensation with the elimination of H2O. Then novaloc is formed. Novaloc is formed. On heating of novaloc, three-dimensional cross-linked polymer is formed, that is called bakelite. This is also one of the condensation polymer. What is the bakelite? Already generally we observe in the houses, switches are bakelite plastic. This is, these switches are bakelite plastic. Okay, next we discuss about comparison of addition and condensation polymerization, or differences between addition and condensation polymerization. We take two columns, addition polymerization, condensation polymerization. Already know that addition polymerization formed by unsaturated same monomers. Unsaturated same monomers. In the condensation polymerization, different functional monomers are participated. In the addition polymerization, unsaturated monomers are participated. In the condensation and polymerization, different functional monomers are participated. This addition polymerization is triggered by heat, pressure or catalyst. Triggering is not necessary in the condensation polymerization. Triggered by heat, pressure or catalyst in the addition polymerization. Triggering is not necessary in the condensation polymerization. Connection. In the addition polymerization, reaction is very fast. In the condensation polymerization, reaction is slow. Okay, listen. Unsaturated monomers are participated in addition polymerization. Different functional monomers are participated in condensation polymerization. This is triggered by heat, pressure or catalyst in addition polymerization. Triggering is not necessary in condensation polymerization. In addition polymerization, reaction is very fast. In condensation polymerization, reaction is... Okay. In the addition polymerization, high molecular weight compound is formed. In the addition polymerization, high molecular weight compound is formed. In the condensation polymerization, low molecular weight compound is formed. Okay. Polymers are... high molecular weight in addition polymerization. Polymers are of low molecular weight in condensation polymerization. Okay. In addition polymerization, no molecules are removed. In condensation polymerization, small molecules like water, NH3, CH3OH are removed. Okay. Polymers of high molecular weight in addition polymerization. Polymers are of low molecular weight in condensation polymerization. No molecules are removed. Small molecules like water, NH3, CH3OH are removed. Okay, next we discuss about plastics. Plasticity is the ability to undergo change of shape. Okay, which compound is changed to its shape, that compound is called plastic. Plasticity is the ability to undergo change of shape. Shape can be changed by application of pressure, temperature, solvents, public water. Okay, shape of the compound is changed by apply of pressure, heating of temperature, or dissolving in the solvents. Okay, when compound shape is changed by applying pressure or heating or dissolving in solvents. Next, plastic is thus any material whose shape can be changed. Plastic is thus any material whose shape can be changed. That means which material shape can be changed, that material is called plastic. Which material shape can be changed by pressure, temperature, or solvents, that material is called plastic. Example, wet clay, floor duct, polyethylene, etc. Generally, we observe plastic material in our surroundings. Generally, plastics are the organic substances. Most of the plastics are organic substances. They have high molecular weight. That molecular weight is greater than 1000. They are polymers. Plastics are polymers. They can be molded into desired form, desired shape by temperature, pressure, both pressure and temperature. Okay. Plastics can be molded into desired shape or form by temperature, pressure, both pressure and temperature. Okay. Most of the plastics are organic substances. They have high molecular weight, that is greater than 1000. Plastics are polymers. Plastics can be molded into desired shape or form by temperature, pressure, both temperature and pressure. Here is an classification of plastics. Plastics are classified into two types: thermoplastics or thermosoftening plastics. Okay, plastics are classified into two types based on heat treatment. First one is thermoplastics or thermosoftening plastics. Second one, thermosetting plastics or thermohardening plastics. Thermoplastics or thermosoftening plastic. Second one, thermosetting plastics or thermohardening plastics. Okay, then first we discuss about thermoplastics. What are the thermoplastics means? The plastics which can be softened on heating and hardened on cooling are called thermoplastics. The plastics which can be softened on heating and hardened on cooling are called thermoplastics. Thermoplastics become soft on heating and remain soft as long as they are hot. On cooling, do not alter the chemical nature because the changes involved are physical nature. Hence, they can be reclaimed from the waste. Okay, thermoplastics become soft on heating and remain soft as long as they are hot. On cooling, do not alter the chemical nature because the changes involved are physical nature. Hence, they can be reclaimed from the waste. Okay. Thermoplastics become soft on heating. They can be remolded into desired shape. Softening, hardening can be repeated by many times by heating or cooling. Setting is temporary. The shape or setting is temporary. Okay. Thermoplastics become soft on heating, hard on cooling. These plastics can be remolded into desired shape. Softening, hardening can be repeated many times by heating or cooling. Setting is temporary. Next, examples of thermoplastics: polyethylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride, polytetrafluoroethylene, that is Teflon. Examples: polyethylene, polystyrene, polyvinyl chloride, polytetrafluoroethylene, that is Teflon. And this is the polystyrene plastic. These are the polystyrene plastic. These are the examples of thermoplastic. Examples of thermoplastics. This is the thermocol. Here is a thermocol. This is thermocol is also polystyrene. This is also example of thermoplastic. Okay, these are the polyvinyl acetate. These are the polyvinyl acetate. These are the example also thermoplastics. Polyvinyl acetate. Okay, next, this is the example of Teflon. Burette. Burette plastic is Teflon. This is also example of thermoplastics. Okay, next we discuss about thermosetting plastics. Thermosetting plastics. Okay, what are the thermosetting plastics? Means the plastics which cannot be softened on heating. Once they are molded into desired shape are called thermosetting plastics. Okay, the plastics which cannot be softened on heating, once they are molded into desired shape, the shape is not changed, that type of plastics are called thermosetting plastics. Okay, thermosetting plastics are formed by the condensation polymerization, hence they are three-dimensional structure. The monomers in thermosetting plastics held together with strong covalent bonds. The bonds retain their strength even on heating. If any change occur on heating, that change is permanent. So the setting property of thermosetting plastics is irreversible. So they cannot be reclaimed from the waste. Okay, listen. Thermosetting plastics are formed by the condensation polymerization. Hence, they are in three-dimensional structure. The monomers in thermosetting plastics held together with strong covalent bonds. The bonds retain their strength even on heating. If any change occur on heating, the change is permanent. So the setting property of thermosetting plastic is irreversible. So they cannot be reclaimed from the waste. So what is the definition of thermosetting plastic? The plastics which cannot be softened on heating, once they are molded into desired shape, are called thermosetting plastics. Okay, thermosetting plastics become soft on heating and molded into desired shape during manufacture stage only. Become soft on heating and molded into desired shape during manufacture stage only. Next, they become hard after cooling or setting. Never become soft again. Setting is permanent. Examples: bakelite, urea formaldehyde resins. This is about the thermosetting plastics. Okay, this is the example of bakelite. This is the bakelite plastic. This is the example of thermosetting plastics. Bakelite plastic is the example of thermosetting plastic. Generally, computer keyboard is also bakelite plastic. This is also example of thermosetting plastic. Generally, we are using computer keyboard. System plastic is also bakelite plastic. Laptop plastic is also bakelite plastic. Okay, the CPU also bakelite plastic. CPU also, Bakelite plastic. This is also example of thermosetting plastic. Okay, next we discuss about differences between thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Take two columns. In the first column, we take thermoplastics. In the second column, we take thermosetting plastics. Okay. Generally, thermoplastics are formed by addition polymerization. The thermoplastics are prepared by addition polymerization. Thermosetic plastics are prepared by condensation polymerization. So, thermosetic plastics are formed by condensation polymerization. Thermoplastics are linear molecules with negligible crosslinks. Thermoplastics are linear molecules with negligible crosslinks. Thermosetting plastics are three-dimensional molecules with covalent crosslinks. Next, thermoplastics are soft and less brittle. Thermosetting plastics are hard and more brittle. Next, thermoplastics are soft, so they are soluble in organic solvents. Thermosetting plastics insoluble in any solvent. Thermoplastics are remolded by heat and solvents. Thermosetting plastics once set cannot be remolded. Okay. Thermoplastics recycled and reused. That means thermoplastics reclaimed from the waste. Next, thermosetting plastics cannot be recycled. That means thermosetting plastics cannot be reclaimed from the waste. Okay, listen. The differences between thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Thermoplastics are formed by addition polymerization. Thermosetting plastics are formed by condensation polymerization. Thermoplastics are long chain linear molecules. Thermosetting plastics are three-dimensional molecules with covalent crosslinks. Next, thermoplastics are soft and less brittle. So, plasticity is reversible. Thermosetting plastics are hard and more brittle. That means plasticity is irreversible. Next, thermoplastics soluble in organic solvents. Why? Because they are soft and less brittle. Next, thermosetting plastics insoluble in any solvent. Why? Because they are hard and more brittle. Next, thermoplastics are remolded by heat and solvents. Thermosetting plastics once set cannot be remolded. Next, thermoplastics recycled or reused. That means thermoplastics reclaimed from the waste. Thermosetting plastics cannot be recycled. That means thermosetting plastics cannot be reclaimed from the waste. These are the differences between thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Okay, next we discuss about properties of plastics. Already all of you see the plastics in our surroundings. Plastics are light in weight. Plastics resistant to corrosion and insects. Low cost of fabrication to get desired shape products. Good thermal and electrical insulation. Next, high tensile strength. Plastics have high tensile strength. That means that is stretched into longer way. Okay, plastics are light in weight, resistant to corrosion and insects, low cost of fabrication to get desired shape products, good thermal and electrical insulation, high tensile strength. Next, plastics have high refractive index. slow thermal expansion coefficient. If temperature increases, they molded or break. They can be breaked. Okay, next, ease in molding to complicated shapes. Decorative surface effect. Impermeable to water. Okay, water is not observed. The plastics. Okay. They have high refractive index, low thermal expansion coefficient, ease in molding to complicated shapes, decorative surface effect, impermeable to water. Next, plastics have easy workability, that is casting, molding, drilling, etc. The surfaces of plastics are shining and glossy appearance. They are not affected by insects, fungi, virus, etc. Some plastics are highly transparent and translucent. They are chemically inert to acids, oils, action of light, etc. They are able to take variety of colors and shades. They do not fade easily. They are non-biodegradable. These are the properties of plastics or characteristics of plastics. Listen. They are light in weight. They possess very low thermal and electrical conductance. They are resistant to corrosion. Plastics have easy workability, that is casting, molding, drilling, etc. Low fabrication cost to get desired shape products. The surfaces of plastics are shining and glossy appearance. They are impermeable to water. They have high tensile strength. They are not affected by insects, fungi, virus, etc. They have low thermal expansion coefficient. Some plastics are highly transparent and translucent. They are chemically inert to acids, oils, action of light, etc. They are able to take variety of colors and shades. They do not fade easily. They are non-biodegradable. Plastics are non-biodegradable. These are the properties of plastics. Okay, next, summarize this video lesson. Okay, plastics are substance as in which change their shape by temperature, pressure, solvents. Next, plastics are high molecular weight polymers. Plastics classified into thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Softening hardening is reversible in thermoplastics, irreversible in thermosetting plastics. Thermoplastics are addition polymers and have chain structure linear. Thermosetting plastics are condensation polymers having 3D structures. Okay, what we have discussed in this video lesson, plastics are substance as and which change their shape by temperature, pressure, solvents. Plastics are high molecular weight polymers. Plastics classified into thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Softening, hardening is reversible in thermoplastics. Irreversible in thermosetting plastics. Thermoplastics are addition polymers and have chain structure linear. Thermosetting plastics are condensation polymers having 3D structures. Next, we have also discussed these topics also. The process of condensation polymerization with examples. Differences between addition and condensation polymerization. Next, characteristics of plastics or properties of plastics. Okay, we have also discussed about the process of condensation polymerization with examples. Differences between addition and condensation polymerization. Next, characteristics of plastics. Okay, we discussed some multiple choice question, what we have discussed in the video lesson. Which is synthetic polymer? Which is synthetic polymer? Silk, PVC, jute, leather. Synthetic polymer is silk. Silk is the synthetic polymer. A is the correct answer. Which is synthetic polymer means silk. A is the correct answer. Next question. Unsaturated monomer is. Unsaturated means which compound have double or triple bonds? That compound is unsaturated compound. A. CF2 double bond CF2. B. OH CH2 CH2 OH. Next C. NH2 CH2 of 6 NH2. D. NH2 CO NH2. Which compound have double bond, triple bonds between the carbons? Those organic compounds are called unsaturated compound. In these compounds, tetrafluoroethane is the unsaturated compound. This is the CF2 double bond CF2. That means double bond present between two carbons. So this compound is the unsaturated monomer. So our answer is A. A is the correct answer. The next question. Degree of polymerization is molecular weight, number of units, angle, function. That means which indicates degree of polymerization. Number of units indicate degree of polymerization. Okay, addition polymerization or addition polymer has high degree of polymerization. Condensation polymer has low degree of polymerization. Why? Because number of units is more in addition polymerization. Number of units is less in condensation polymerization. So degree of polymerization indicates number of units present in the polymer. So B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. Next, which is polyester following four compounds? A. Nylon. B. Bakelite. C. Terlin. D. Urea formaldehyde. Okay, which is polymer? A. Nylon. Nylon is the polyester. Which is polyester? Nylon is the polyester. Remaining all are plastics, not polyesters. So A is the correct answer. Nylon is polyester. A is the correct answer. Bakelite is an example of addition polymerization, condensation polymerization, copolymerization, none of the above. Already we have discussed in this video lesson. Bakelite is the example of condensation polymerization. Okay. In the formation of bakelite, phenol and formaldehyde are participated. First, orthoparamethylol phenols are formed. Those are condensed by the elimination of H2O and form novolac. Novolac, on heating novolac, that is form bakelite. So bakelite is an example of condensation polymerization. B is the correct answer. Next question. Condensation polymerization is also known as chain polymerization, step growth polymerization, copolymerization, addition polymerization. Already we have discussed condensation polymerization is also known as step growth polymerization. Okay, condensation polymerization is also known as step growth polymerization. So B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. Step growth polymerization is the correct answer. Next question. Which of the following is thermoplastic? A. Bakelite. B. Urea formaldehyde resin. C. Polyvinyl acetate. D. All of the above. Okay. These three, bakelite is not thermoplastic. Urea formaldehyde resin is also not thermoplastic. Polyvinyl acetate is the thermoplastic. So C is the correct answer. Bakelite, urea formaldehyde are thermosetting plastics. Polyvinyl acetate is thermoplastic. So C is the correct answer. Okay. Polyvinyl acetate is thermoplastic. Next, which of the following is thermosetting plastic? PVC, polystyrene, Teflon, urea formaldehyde resin. Already we have discussed urea formaldehyde resin is thermosetting plastic. Thermosetting plastic. D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Okay, what we have discussed in the video lessons, some questions are frequently asked in the examination. Those questions are: define polymer. Next one, what do you mean by polymerization? Mention types of polymerization. Define addition polymerization and explain with an example. Write the characteristics of addition polymerization. Define degree of polymerization. What are homo and copolymers? Give examples. Okay, which type of questions are asked in the examination? Define polymer. What do you mean by polymerization? Mention types of polymerization. Define addition polymerization and explain with an example. Write the characteristics of addition polymerization. Define degree of polymerization. What are homo and copolymers with examples? Next, some more questions are also asked in the examination. Define a thermoplastic, give examples. Define a thermosetting plastic, give examples. Compare thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. And also ask sometimes, write the characteristics of plastics. Okay, define a thermoplastic, give examples. Define a thermosetting plastic, give examples. Compare thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. And also sometimes will be asked like, write the characteristics of plastics. Okay, sometimes some more questions are also asked like this. Explain condensation polymerization with an example. Write the characteristics of condensation polymerization. Compare addition and condensation polymerization. How Bakelite is formed, formulate the reaction. Okay. Love you. Thank you for the listening of this video lesson. Thank you.